Research and education programs in the basic sciences at Penn State are among the top programs in the United States, according to a comprehensive new National Research Council study titled A Data-Based Assessment of Research Doctorate Programs in the United States. The study uses a broad range of measurements to rank the performance of over 5,000 graduate programs in 62 fields at 212 U.S. universities. By any interpretation of this comprehensive study, Penn State now ranks among the best universities in the basic sciences in the United States.
What I like very much about this new report is the fact that it's not purely reputational, that they looked at honest-to-goodness metrics and tried to rank colleges and departments on the basis of verifiable numbers. I think it's probably groundbreaking in the sense that it's not purely reputational.
During the years since the 1995 report was published, the core programs in all of the seven academic departments in the college have risen dramatically in the new National Research Council rankings. The new National Research Council study, which ranks graduate programs, is widely viewed as a gauge of faculty quality and research productivity, both of which contribute to the quality of undergraduate programs. The report positions individual doctoral programs within a range of quality as gauged by two different ranking methods, called R and S, which assign different levels of importance to 20 measures of quality. Each program receives a ranking range, rather than a simple rank, to reflect the range of statistical confidence in the results.
If you look across the basic sciences, there are a lot of universities that are very good, that have developed strengths in one area or another, but it's rare to have the strengths across the basic sciences that we've developed.
The new NRC gauges of quality can be analyzed in a number of ways. One conservative approach of equal weighting of the National Research Council's R and S methodologies shows that the Department of Astronomy and Astrophysics at Penn State rose from number 21 in the 1995 report to number 4 in the new 2011 report. The Department of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology at Penn State rose from number 45 to number 29, and the Department of Chemistry rose from being tied for the number 18 spot to number 12. Meanwhile, the Department of Mathematics rose from number 37 to number 7, and the Department of Physics rose from number 55 to number 13. The Department of Statistics rose from number 19 to number 9. The Department of Biology, which was not directly ranked in the earlier study, is now ranked at number 15. Another equally conservative approach, based on the distance from the ideal ranking of the center of each R and S range, yields slightly different yet similar results. Applying similar analyses to the National Research Council ranges for all top universities in the study reveals that there is a group of six elite universities in the basic sciences: Harvard, Berkeley, Princeton, Caltech, Stanford, and MIT, and that, by any conservative analysis, Penn State Science is very near the top, or at the top, of the next tier of the top 10 elite universities nationwide.
What I'm so excited about with the NRC rankings is I think that knowledgeable people, first, prospective faculty, secondly, prospective graduate students, will see these rankings and take them very seriously. And I think the NRC rankings then really just raise the value of everything that we're doing here.
Penn State programs in other areas, particularly in the College of Liberal Arts, made impressive gains in the National Research Council rankings as well.
What has worked for us is building an environment where excellent people, faculty, and students see opportunity. Part of that environment has to do with building connections across the disciplines, and Penn State has done that extremely well.